The PSE index smashing a key resistance level yesterday, jumping nearly 2% to close at 68.33. It looks like a weekly gain is already a sure thing, with a number to beat pretty far off, 66.67. About 150 points away from that. So we're going to have to fall so much today not to be able to not post a weekly gain. We want to bring in now Ron Nakoboff, Trading Edge Consultancy, for his take. Good to see you, Ron. Hi.
Hi, Mimi. Thank you for having me, and Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. U.S. inflation, I want to get your reaction to that. Let's talk about what that means. Together, of course, with the Fed's resolve, how that could influence fund flows to equities in general and to emerging markets like the Philippines specifically?
Well, if you go back to last year, the major catalyst of volatility really is the surge in inflation and hence the surge in interest rates. As you recall, U.S. inflation jumped to a 40-year high of 9.1% in June last year, which led the U.S. Federal Reserve to aggressively hike their interest rates by 425 basis points to a multi-year high of 5.5%. Now with U.S. inflation tapering from the said high to about 7% or even lower in the previous months, and even in the succeeding months of the present year, the U.S. Federal Reserve is only expected to hike not by 425 basis points, which it had last year, but by only 100 basis points. So that's a big contrast, a big difference. So with a less tightening monetary environment, there's now more room for risk assets to rally and recover.
Mm-hmm. And when there's more room for risk assets to rally, geographically speaking, do you expect fund flows to move from developed to emerging, or the other way around?
Definitely. Whenever the monetary environment gets a little bit loose, or in our case, presently gets less tight, then we can expect fund flows to go back from developed to emerging and more riskier assets. In fact, if you look at I don't have the chart for you, but if you look at the charts of, say, for example, the MSCI Emerging Market Asia Index and the MSCI Philippines Index, if you look at both of them, they actually have already pivoted to the upside. So they're on the verge of, not on the verge, but they are already starting their own new bull trend. Mm-hmm. So with that, we can expect definitely fund flows to continue entering into the not only in the region, but specifically into our country, the Philippines.
All right. We'll get to the technicals for the Philippines if in a while. But I wanted to, before we end the segment on the central bank, I wonder how markets feel about this. It seems like it's a damned if you do, damned if you don't scenario. I mean, when central banks go too far with tightening or stop too soon, either way, it's going to be a mistake and markets are going to just go wild.
Well, it depends, because on the other side of the sea, there's the Fed that is the main influence of domestic decisions. So the BSP is actually put in the place whether they would either follow the aggressive stance of the Federal Reserve, U.S. Federal Reserve, or focus on what's happening domestically. Actually, in my opinion, if you ask me, one of the major reasons, aside from the aggressive hikes in the U.S. The downside volatility that we have locally last year, was the BSP's reluctance to be ahead of the curve and match the degree of the hike that the U.S. did last year. Why? As you know, domestic inflation reached a four-year high of 8.1 as of December last year. And if you recall, the BSP during the first and second quarter didn't actually want to hike, stating that the increase in inflation for several times was only transitionary. But as you know, inflation last year kept on rising to new highs and new highs until we had until we reach a high of 8.4. So clearly the BSP failed to be ahead of the curve. So the right move looking back was for the BSP to at least match the degree of the hike of the Fed, which in turn would preserve the interest rate differential between the US and the Philippines.
All right, we actually had the governor here yesterday, and here's what he said. Let's listen to this.
We need not match that, but we cannot. If it's 50, I think it's hard not to match. It's hard not to respond, at least partially.
All right. So that's what the governor said.
I don't really understand what he said, but as you
he
know,
doesn't. He says we don't have to match them point by point, but partially at least we need to respond.
Well, given the inflation figures and the inflation trend in the U.S., as you know, inflation trend in the U.S. has been tapering from the 9.1 high that it had in June towards 7 to close the towards the end of last year. On the other hand, so inflation in the U.S. has been improving. That's why the Fed has already, at least verbally, starting to communicate that it will not be as aggressive for the present year.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. On the other hand, this is not the case for the Philippines, because the Philippines, in 9 out of 12 months of last year, we have seen inflation rise. In fact, we closed last year to a four-year high of 8.1%. So the highest level in 4 years, definitely the highest level that we've seen last year. So the trend is clearly still up. So if you base your decisions based on that, obviously any central bank's mandate should be to try to stabilize domestic prices, then the BSP should continue to be aggressive.
All right. Okay, Ron, of course, every analyst has his own recommendations, but I just wanted to bring in the PSEI opening flat, but now it's actually to the downside. It's in the red, down by 0.25%, 17.6816. You briefly touched on this, but on a more detailed basis, how is the technical setup looking for the Philippine market, and are the technicals aligned with the fundamentals at this point?
Technicals are definitely aligned with fundamentals, both of the Philippines and the region. If you look at how the PSEI has performed, chart-wise, it appears to be that the PSEI is on the verge of pivoting from a notable base, while presently it's trading right at its resistance area at around 6.8, which is the high that it reached back in August in 2022. Improving market breadth, looking at a lot of individual stocks. As I've mentioned, the positive pivot seen in the regional indices like the Emerging Market Asia Index and the MSCI Philippines Index, and even the peso dollar exchange rate all suggest that the bulls may finally take control of the driver's seat. We'll see in the next few weeks. We're not even going to wait several months. We'll know whether a pivot will happen for the PSEI in the coming weeks.
Ah, all right. We're going to be watching with you. But for now, let's take a look at some interesting corporate stories. You know, it's pretty quiet in the disclosures. It's quiet today, but I imagine the next few weeks are going to be crazy because earnings season will start to roll in. So we're just going to have to enjoy the peace and quiet for now. But so far, here are the stories. We have Megaworld is set to open its fourth Savoy Hotel brand. This time, it's going to be in Palawan. It's Paragua Coast Town in Palawan. It's also their 17th hotel in portfolio. Just very quickly, the hotel players, accommodation industry, are you bullish?
Well, for Megaworld, the the hotel that they're opening soon in Palawan is part of the integrated development they're building in the province, similar to what it has it what it has in Boracay. Mm-hmm. So so obviously opening one or having one and then continuing to build a commercial district and then eventually your condos and others would definitely enhance the value of what they have in the province and in their portfolio in general, and also I might say contribute to increase tourism in the province.
All right. San Miguel Corporation saying that 350,000 households in Bulacan are going to get clean water by 2025. We know that Mr. Ramon Ang has been busy building in Bulacan, where his airport is supposed to happen. Is Bulacan the next place to be in, you think?
At present, I think San Miguel is already supplying 13 districts, which distributes to already 220,000 households. Mm-hmm. So what they plan to open as of 2025 is part of their program, part of the bulk water project that they have in that particular province. In their attempt to serve and cover the growing demand in the province. So yeah, I think it's the place to begin. As you mentioned, they're currently building an airport, and whenever you have a transportation hub, much so an airport, then definitely business activity would follow, expectedly increase sooner or later.
All right, fintech and telco players Maya, GCash, Globe Telecom, they're joining the government in the Paleng QR PH initiative. You know, it's pretty quiet in the disclosures. I'm looking at the list right now, Ron, and I've only got, let me see, 7-8 disclosures, and all of them are share buyback transactions from Alliance Global, Costco Capital, Robinson's Land, Metro Retail, Stores Group. When you're an investor and you look at the disclosures and all you see are share buyback transactions, what does that tell you?
Well, it tells you that the companies themselves sees value in their own shares, given the present price. Mm-hmm. So definitely that's a positive sign. If you look at how AGI, for example, has performed over the past several weeks, it has risen quite fast, following the news of its of a renewed and increased buyback program. So definitely, anytime you would see continued buyback from insiders, like executives of the companies and the companies themselves, that's a positive sign.
All right. Ron, we've come to the most exciting part of the conversation, the blind item. Talk to us about the stock that you're monitoring closely. Don't tell us, just describe. What do you have for us?
It's one of the biggest banks in the country. I used to work for that bank as an equity.
You're giving it away to your friends.
As an equity fund manager, like a decade or 12 years ago.
Okay.
12 years ago, if I, it's in the process of merging with Gokong Waste Robinson.
There you go. Okay. So why do you like this stock?
Well, I like it because chart-wise, as you can see, I believe it has already pivoted from a very very wide base the moment that it surpassed the 100 handle. With that, I expect it to eventually revisit its all-time high of 120. And not just this bank. If you look at its competitors, let's say BDOs and even Metro Bank, all of them are positioning the same.
Okay. Ron, thank you so much for the not so blind item today. All right, but let's see. We're gonna wait. You know, our viewers do tweet their guesses. Thank you so much, Ron. Always a pleasure speaking with you. See you soon.
See you.
All right.